मॉर्निंग मैम, आई वुड लाइक टू प्रेजेंट माई स्क्रीन। माई टॉपिक फॉर टूडे इज कंसेप्ट ऑफ टॉर्टियस लाइबिलिटी ऑफ स्टेट। When a child does a mistake, his parents punishes him. Likewise, when a citizen does a mistake, the state punishes him. One may wonder, what if the state itself does a mistake? What happens then? Let's find out in the upcoming slides. Now let's analyze the tortious liability of England and India. How England is compared to India. In England, before the Crown Proceeding Act of 1947, the maxim res non potest peccara held supreme, which simply meant the king can do no wrong and the state was not held liable for the acts of its servants. But after the enactment of Crown Proceeding Act of 1947, it was held that the king can be sued and is not exempted from all the liabilities, and the maxim respondet superior was held supreme, which simply meant let the principal be liable and the state was held liable for the acts of its servants. In contrast to England, in India, there is no such enactment and each state liability is seen from case to case basis. Moving on, now let's analyze how the liability of a state evolved in India. Before the independence of 1947, through the Government of India Acts of 1858 and 1950, it was the Secretary of State who was named in the various state liability cases. Further, in 1935, it was Federation of India and the provinces who were being named in the state liability cases. After the independence of 1947, under Indian Constitution, under Article 294B, the liability of the Union out of any contract or otherwise is discussed. The word otherwise here is very important because otherwise includes the various tortious liabilities of the state. Further, in Article 300, it is mentioned that the state may sue or may be sued. Having seen all of that, now let's analyze how the concept of a state liability developed in India through various case laws. The instant case is a very famous case law. In the instant case of P&O Steam Navigation Co. versus the Secretary of State, there was a certain horse carriage who met with an accident due to the negligence of a government employee. In the instant case, the court classified the States Act into two parts, first being sovereign and second being non-sovereign. Sovereign simply was defined as if the work is for the defense of the country, making peace or war, foreign affairs, or acquiring and retaining territory. And non-sovereign functions included construction works, trade, and other commercial works. So after the independence, let's analyze the post-constitutional cases, how the law developed further in India. In the state of Rajasthan versus Vidyavati case, the court held that the doctrine of sovereign immunity founded on the English law had no validity in India. But this judgment was overruled in the upcoming case, that is Kasturi Lal versus State of UP. In the instant case, gold and silver was seized by the police but was misappropriated by the head constable. And the Supreme Court ruled that a state was not liable as the police officers were merely exercising the sovereign functions. And this instant case is popularly criticized for its ambiguity. In the further case of Neelabati Behra versus State of Orissa, where a child died in police custody. But here, the Supreme Court sidelined the judgment laid down in Kasturi Lal versus State of UP and gave the verdict utilizing the wide scope of Article 21 and held the state liable.
Manish, little bit speed up.
Yes, I guess. On a conclusive note, I would like to point out that the laws laid down in Kasturi Lal's case is no longer being followed and is sidelined. as because after the expansion of the scope of Article 21 and the evolution of compensatory jurisprudence under Article 32 and 226, the concept of sovereign and non-sovereign function has become outdated, and it is found that often the state is held liable
the names
for the
of the students. I'll give a topic.
So if you want, you can
continue.
It is found that it is a state who is often held liable for the tortious acts of its servants. Thank you.
So what was the outcome in Kasturi Lal's case?
The court defined the court followed the old doctrine of sovereign and non-sovereign and held that the police does not do sovereign function and did not return the gold of Kasturi Lal or not even paid the adequate compensation to the Kasturi Lal, and this judgment is often criticized for being ambiguous.